In this video, I'm going to show you how to draw using the grid method. So the first thing we do, I've got a 11x12 sketchbook here, and I'm going to mark off every inch of the top here. So I line the 9-inch off the edge, and I'm going to mark every inch. Do the same thing down at the bottom, marking out every inch. And then I'm going to join those lines together. So I line up the dots with my ruler and then draw a line. So for this, you can use an HB pencil. I'm using an H pencil. Anything that won't smudge would be a good idea, so not a B pencil. Now I need to mark the vertical lines. So I line up the top edge with the zero, and I mark off every inch. And in my photo, the green lines show the 1-inch markings, and the white lines are 1/2 inch between those green lines. So I'm going to mark it on this side as well, because we only need 2 points to make a straight line. So I'm going to mark every inch on this side as well. And then I line up those marks that I made to make my horizontal lines. The main part of the boat is between A and D and 7 and 9. So I'm going to add 1/2 marks in those areas. Okay, I'm zoomed in on the boat area, and I'm going to write the names of the columns right here as well. Starting on the left side of the boat here, so it starts between 7 and 8 and close to the B line. So between 7 and 8, a little closer to the halfway point there. So it starts here and it ends at below 8 and pretty much at B, right about here. So I'll draw that line. And now looking at the front of the boat here, this point here is above 8 and almost at D, so right about here. And then the bottom point is at 8.5, just below 8.5, and further in than this point, so right about there. So I'll draw that line. That line's pretty straight. Now I can attach these. Turn on the side a bit. So I'm going to attach this line to the other line. And this line curves a bit more at the start. And then it's fairly straight. I'm looking at the canopy, one on line that ends up just about 7B, just below 7, so between 7 and 7.5 out here. And then the canopy goes out a bit and down a bit. And from that point there, we have a line. And we have another line coming from that point. This has a bit of width to it. And then the other side, that point is right on C and about halfway, a little more than halfway between here and here. So curve that, and then we have another line there. There's three lines up here, so only three lines. Then we have this other little piece here. It is at halfway between B and C, and it starts on a halfway line, and it's also halfway between 7 and 7.5. So there's a line going up, and the other side of that is just below what we already drew here. So curved line there, and curved line out to there. So I'm going to draw the window here, which is centered around the line between B and C. So it's the bottom that's parallel. And it curves. Curved line on the top, and there's a line in the middle, right about there. So now we take the white line above that, and it starts straight, but then curves out. And as it gets over to C, it's another straight line. And once it gets past C, it's a little shorter and goes to D, closer to D. So going like that, and the pole for the boat here is just past C, so there's a bit of a another white piece here. And this is where our pole starts. I'm going to attach the ropes here to the boat. So I'll start drawing in that. There is another white line that has the same height as this and goes up to the pole there and around. So attach it to that front piece there. I'm not going to worry about the figures right now. I will mark in it. These are some dark lines in here, and where our windows are. So we have on the side here, we have only one here, and then one between B and C, close to 8. So right about here, see mine here. And there's one here at the bottom of the boat. And I can draw this line going up to the boat. Okay, I've zoomed back out to finish this off. And the pole for the mast here ends up just on the left side between C and D. I have my part point I've marked, so it's going to end up about here. So above line 2 and just to the left, a little closer to the middle, but on the other side of C. So I've started to draw the pole here, and I will finish it off here. It doesn't start quite up at the top, it starts just a little below, so right about here. And this one gets a little wider as it gets to the bottom. And I scrolled up. Now we need the inlines that come out of the side. So the first one is up here. So between 4, just above 4 here. So this one comes out fairly straight and goes to C. And on this side, it goes down and it goes past what we just drew. And then down here at 5.5, and about here, we have an arm coming past C and going slightly up. And then this arm is going down and goes as far as the other one we drew. Well, there's one more piece we have to draw down here. From here. So it's just above this canopy back here. And it doesn't quite hit the halfway mark, so from here to about here, and then, so that is that, and attached to that we have this little tiny mast here that starts above 6.5, and goes out. So we have a line going from the top to this arm, and from one arm to the next arm, and from that arm down to the center. We can get back from the top to here, from here to here. And then from here down here. Now on this side we have lines from the top all the way down to that bar that I created. A line from here to the next arms. And from these arms down pretty much the middle of that bar thing. And this line here goes down to another chip out here. It's below 6.5. We have this line that comes down here. And then across that. And over here. That's how to draw the grid. I hope you enjoyed it.